Howdy folks, Jambareeqi here. I've just been to see the Boxtrolls with my classmates Callie and Jamie. For those of you who don't know, the Boxtrolls is a stop-motion animated feature from the company known as Laika, the same studio that produced Paranorman and Coraline, okay? Now, the Boxtrolls is about a group of trolls that live underground and wear cardboard boxes, and one of the trolls is actually a little boy who thinks he's a troll. Now, the thing is, these trolls like to go up to the upper level, onto our level, and go to the streets and find things to take back to their lair. But there's an exterminator and his little minions going through the streets at night taking care of these box trolls. That's as much as I can say without revealing details or spoilers, but yeah, that's the film in a nutshell. So, the box trolls is okay. It's good. It's a passable effort, okay? It's charming. It's a charming movie. It's very charming. The Boxtrolls themselves are very weird and funny and entertaining and really adorable. They're very cute. I mean, like, if you like the Minions, then you'll like the Boxtrolls. I mean, like, they even have like a weird language as well. They have a made-up language as well, a bit like the Minions. So they've got the same kind of novelty as the Minions, so yeah. The child characters as well, they're really great because a lot of child characters in kids' movies tend to be just typical everyday kids, but these kids are weird in a good way. They're entertainingly weird. They are strange children. And the thing is, kids can be weird, so it's believable, but these kids are really odd. But I like that. I really like that. And the film also has a really good cast. There's like recognisable British actors like Richard Iode, Simon Pegg, Nick Frost, people like that. And one of the Boxtrolls is voiced by Steve Blum. Yeah. So one of the Boxtrolls actually sounds like Guillemon from Digimon. How cool is that? Yeah, so it's got great characters, great voice acting. It's just not as impressive or imaginative or creative as the first two films. I think the great thing about Laika is that the novelty of Laika is that they produce horror films for kids that retain the wonder and magic of stop motion animation. But this film is very friendly and tame in comparison to Coraline and Paranorman. Now, this is good in one case because if you consider that some kids don't like horror films, so maybe this is more accessible to those kids. But there are also kids that like horror films, so it might be disappointing to them. And there are people like me who follow the animation studio Laika and want to see something like Coraline, like Paranorman, another stop-motion horror film. But this film isn't meant to be scary. It's pretty much a family-friendly romp. But it's a good family-friendly romp, okay? It's just not as great or amazing as Paranorman or Coraline, disappointingly. But I was never annoyed, I was never bored, I was never confused. I liked it. It's a good effort. It's very funny, it's very cute, and it's very charming. So for what it is, it's okay. So I hope that paints a picture and makes you consider whether you should see the film as well. That's my thoughts on the Boxtrolls. Cheerio, folks.